prison, but I had the stove and got rich. A nigga, you know what we're doing. I'm a hustling to get myself a Cuban. It was all about the butter. I ain't stutter, ain't no Reuben. I got a lot of money in the ball, man. Mix it with the czar. Anytime I'm stepping on the go, dog.
Now we are back at Dave's. We're doing strength and conditioning. It's getting closer to the fight, so we're just focusing on the conditioning aspect. No more strength training, really, because now we're starting to spar a lot of rounds, you know, 8 to 10 rounds. So when we do weights and stuff like that, it kind of gets in the way of the training. Right now, I'm just incorporating this swimsuit, actually, which helps you sweat along with this. This is actually a trick that not a lot of people know about, just the boxing people. You rub Albaline all over your body and you'll sweat pretty much 3 times more than you normally sweat. So that's a trick for you guys or women that want to lose weight quickly or get more out of their workout. So that's pretty much what's going on today.
All right, so this week got a text message from Julian's father and trainer, obviously, Alex Devia. And at this point in the camp, we're taking it down a little bit from the weight training, the resistance training, so he's not as sore, and take a little bit more weight off. So we're up in the cardiovascular component, a little bit more of the circuit training component to get his weight down a little bit and start getting more acclimated for the latter rounds of the fight and sparring.
Punching the trainer. No kidney shots to the trainer.
What are you talking about?
What?
Okay. So actively resting, I'd never allow him to get under like maybe 160. I keep him up there. And he'll tax it out here. He'll get up there to like 180-ish. It's the recovery that's the most important. He recovers very quickly. So even when he's very high in the 180 range, within a minute he'll be back down to like a green zone, like around 120-ish easily.
I mean, the thing is, we have 3 weeks left of the fight and I'm only about 10 pounds, so it's not really you know, that's not, we don't really need to strategize for that, considering we're actually ahead of the game plan, because I'm losing weight super quickly, and that has to do with the meals I'm eating, and you know, I'm only drinking water, so it's really easy to come off.
You have 20 each side.
Best healthy food ever. What you gotta do is take the top off. I'm only gonna eat about half of this. Heat it up for about, I heat it up for about 7 minutes. It's all done.
What you guys doing?
We're playing Minecraft.
You playing Minecraft?
I won't be this evil.
Why don't you say hi to the camera?
Hi.
What's your name?
Jaden.
What's your name?
Jaden.
What's your name?
Ivory Devia.
This is my brother Josh.
No. I don't know.
This is the fam.
Can we watch y'all play?
It's like, Jane, no.
We should start
No, let's start again. I had to go in Josh's world.
That game, Minecraft, not even lying to you, is the most boringest game ever.
Yes, it is.
So why you play it so much?
Yeah! I don't care, I don't want to die. I just saw a monster.
This is turkey meatballs with some brown rice. I'm not gonna eat all of it right now because it's pretty, it's kind of heavy. So I don't want to. I got to spar in about an hour, so. Right now we're actually on the way to the gym. It's Tuesday, so that means it's sparring day. Come on. Generally sparring days are Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. So right now I'm about to probably go around 8 rounds. Just getting down my timing, and then next week we'll bring it up to maybe 8 to 10 rounds, and then bring it back down for like cool off week, you know. So right now it's just sparring. I think I'm sparring 2 different guys. That's about it. Then we train afterwards, and tonight I'll go for a run. And that's pretty much summing up the day for today.
Yeah, it's a great time. So once we lost the Olympic trials, close decision, he said, "Dad, I want to do the Golden Gloves and I want to turn pro. Because I just want to show everybody that I am the best 141 in the country." And he did. He didn't lose a round. We fought 5 fights. We didn't lose 1 round. And right after that, we turned pro. We're coming. That's what I do know is that we're coming. We're coming down like a shopping cart full of bricks downhill. Straight.
We're 2 weeks out. September 8th. What did we do today? Like, what was going on today?
Today was a great sparring session. You know, we got 8 rounds in. He looked great. You know what I mean? His legs, his jab, his hand speed, you know what I'm saying? It was awesome. It was good sparring today.
Honestly, bro, like, I just see, like, opportunity, man, you know? You know, I'm from Jersey, and I feel like because all my life I was 5 to 10 minutes from the city, I don't really take advantage of what really the city holds, you know? There's, I just think of bright lights, you know? Bright lights. I fight at the Garden all the time, so it just reminds me of that. You know, that's part of the reason why I like running over here on this track, because every time I make that loop and I look at these buildings, it just reminds me of just the bright lights that I know I belong in, you know?
And you wouldn't want this for your son at all?
I don't want this for my son? So many people ask me, "Oh, you want him to fight? He's gonna be a fighter too, huh?" No, hell no. That's why I get hit in the head every day, so that my family could live great, not good, great. You know, and of course that's including my son. It's just because the reason why is because I know what it takes for you to be really successful in this sport. A lot of my friends are already world champions. A lot of my friends are multi-millionaires. My son Jaden was born in the gym. Every time I have him, he's in the gym with me. By the time he's 7, 8 years old, he's gonna be sick of that shit, man. He's not gonna wanna come to the gym. For what, to sit in a sweaty gym and watch me train? Hey man, you never know. He may look back at my tapes, or he may be watching me on TV, he may be walking me out to the ring, and that just might strike something in his heart, bro, and he just might, you know. The only way I'll let it go is if he really proves it to me, man. If he really works hard
You know, a lot of fighters' kids end up training and trying to pursue the sport, and they fall right on their face, man. And it's embarrassing because it kind of ruins the father's legacy, you know. Black diamond got his ties in it. I got a first class ticket to put the pies in it. I put a couple of bitches and kick it down, make a shit when a nigga ice is the light to hypnotize your bitch. Niggas need to get that shit.